Hi everyone, hope you're all doing very well. I'm really sorry I wasn't able to create a video this week and I just realized that the last video came 7 days before. So before this weekend ended, I just knew that I had to create something which was on one hand quick to make and on the other still useful. So I thought let's address this question of freshers versus work experience, because a lot of times in the comments I've been asked by freshers that if you don't have any work experience, is it looked down upon during the interviews? Like, why would I even get selected if I don't have any value to add? I feel like that's not the right approach, and hence I wanted to show you how many freshers were there in my batch, which is 2018-2020 batch of IIM Ahmedabad. And then at the same time, a lot of people with work experience also worry that would it cause some hindrance in getting into an IIM. So I thought I'll share that as well and show you exactly how many months of experience my batchmates had. So the first thing that I would like to show you is this table in which I've plotted the months of work experience that my batchmates had. On the left hand column, you can see the work experience in terms of months, and in the right hand side column, you can see how many batchmates had that much experience. This table gives so many interesting insights. For example, the first thing that anyone would notice is that there were 144 freshers in my batch. That's an absolutely huge number, because if you see that the total batch strength was 410, this makes 35% freshers. I was also a fresher, so I remember worrying constantly about the fact that how will I even add value to my batch coming with no work experience. So if there's anyone watching this video who is a fresher, this table in front of you is a great evidence that you don't really have to worry about that fact. If 144 freshers can make it, then so can you. There's nothing stopping you. Another interesting insight is for people with work experience. So if you see, there's a long range when it comes to how many months of work experience my batchmates had. I had a batchmate with just 1 month of work experience as well, and then there was someone with 55 months of experience as well. And that's not really an upper cap. I'm pretty sure that people with experience more than 55 must have been present in my previous batches or in the subsequent batches. So if you are someone with a lot of work experience or too little work experience and you're worrying that that outlier number is going to cause hindrance, then the number per se does not matter. These examples in front of you prove just that. In fact, if you're worrying about your overall profile, then I would highly recommend you to watch this video, which shows what exactly makes you get into an IIM. This might help you with building your case, but the number per se of how many experience months you have does not matter. And the same holds true for placements as well. I understand that for a lot of you, the end goal is going to be getting placed out of an IIM. So if you're worrying that being a fresher may cause some problem getting into consulting, maybe MBB, or maybe into finance and the top firms, then the answer is no. It's not going to cause any hindrance. I've had batchmates going into the same firms, one person with a lot of experience and one person with no experience at all. So it does not matter. Trust me, the experience per se does not matter. Yes, it can definitely add value to the batch, but if you can bring forth the value in other ways, then you don't really need that experience to get into the firm that you want to. The next insight was pretty interesting, and I also did not know this until I had plotted this data. So what I noticed was that there were huge spikes at certain numbers, for example, 6 months or 7 months, and then you also see the same spikes at around 18 months, 19 months, and then at 30 months. So I don't know why this exactly takes place, but probably people see 6+ months of work experience to be a good enough range, which is why there's a huge spike at 6 months. Similarly, if you see 18 months, which is 1.5 years, probably a lot of people consider that to be a good number in terms of work experience that you should have before getting into a B school. I used to think that it's probably 2 years, but then I figured after plotting this data that it's actually 1.5 years. And at the same time, if you look at the numbers 30, that's probably where the spike ends, and people don't want to have more than that experience. So the number after that keeps reducing. After 3 years, there are very few students who have more than that experience. Same holds true for people with less than 6 months of work experience, very few students with that much experience. So I believe like 6 months plus 2-3 years is a range which people prefer when it comes to getting into B schools. But keep in mind that people with more or less than that also make it. So it's no rule or regulation which says that you have lesser chances of making it. It's generally what people try to ensure when getting into a B school. Finally, let me share my take on being a fresher and how it was different from people with work experience. There's this general notion on campus as well that someone with no work experience can bring forth fresh perspectives onto the table, which people with experience are sometimes not able to because of having a couple of months of experience of working in a certain kind of an industry or a sector. So a lot of times when there are case discussions and we need to brainstorm a lot of ideas and we need to come up with out-of-the-box solutions, freshers can often do a better job at it because they don't really have that constraint of having worked in a certain industry. So if you're a fresher and you're worrying that you need 2+ years of work experience before getting into an IIM, or that may help you more as compared to being a fresher, personally, I would disagree. Like when I look back, I feel like yes, work experience may have helped me put across better ideas in the classroom setting. But looking back, I don't really regret my decision because I would have ultimately also landed at the same place. So having or not having work experience really did not make any difference when it comes to the final placement or the stay at IIM Ahmedabad or anything very major in general. So what I'm trying to say is that having work experience can help, but at the same time, it's no hindrance if you don't have any work experience. Hope this video clarifies a couple of doubts that you might have had. If you still have any, please feel free to use the comment section. And thanks for watching the video.